AquaShield is a smart monitoring and controlling device specially designed for indoor farming. In the previous video, we already showed you how to start your AquaShield. Now we will continue this journey and build a relay box so you will also be able to control it. If the AquaShield is the brain, this relay box is going to be its muscle. With this hardware, you will be able to automate almost all the jobs you have in your indoor garden. AquaShield can handle 8 relays, so you can have 8 active components that is controlled by the workflows you created in the AquaShield software. For easier use, we will add electrical sockets, so you can connect your grow lights, pumps, valves without any modification. We use off-the-shelf components to build the relay box, so you can build it from the parts that you find at your local electrical shop. However, you can also order it from us. Let's check out what parts we use. Also, we listed all the components in the description. First and foremost, you will need an electrical box. We will use a simple modular electrical box with IP42 protection, but we could also use a waterproof box if needed. The relay box will be placed next to an indoor hydroponic system, so this time we won't need a waterproof design. In the box, we could fit 2 relays with 2 electrical sockets. So if you would like to have more controlled connections, you will need a bigger box. All sockets will have its own circuit breakers, so you will be able to shut down all the devices independently. With this, if one of the equipment has a fault, only that will be shut and the other devices can still work. For life protection, you should always use a GFCI or ground fault circuit interrupter module. We won't install one into this box because we already have one installed in the main electrical feed. For easier cable management, we will use terminals. And as all the parts are designed to be mounted, we will mount them on a rail that is already installed in the box. So let's get started. For better protection against dust and water, and also for a clean look, we use some cable glands at the bottom of the box. The size of the cable gland should be suitable for the cable diameter you use for a tight grip. First, we place every part into the relay box. I will use this small flat screwdriver to open and close the mounting mechanism. I will start with the terminals. Then the circuit breakers. And then the relays. With this, we have the first controlled connection, and now we will move on to the second one. Now that all components are in place, let's talk about the wiring. From the terminal, we will connect the wires to the circuit breakers, to the relays, and to the sockets. It is important that you should connect the live wire through the circuit breaker and only then to the relay. The neutral and the ground goes directly to the socket. For better understanding the wiring, I will remove the rail from the box and connect the neutral and ground wires. Now let's connect the ground or earth wires. let's move on connecting the live wires. First, we will connect the terminal with the circuit breakers. Now the circuit breakers are connected to the terminal, and the only thing left with the power distribution is to connect the relays to the electrical sockets, and you are good to go. First, we will connect the relays with the electrical sockets. The final step is to connect the circuit breakers with the relays. With this last step, the wiring is almost complete. It is time to move the unit back to the electrical box. When the relay box is ready, we will need to connect the relays with the AquaShields control module. For this, we will need a pair of cable at each relay. So we will use this 4-wire cable. We already installed a power cable and a 4-wire cable, so the relay box is ready to work and automate all jobs, so you can sit back, relax and enjoy your garden. The wire size and material you use should be always large enough to handle the amp rate on the circuit breaker. In our case, we use 6 amp circuit breakers with a 1.5 square millimeter or 16 gauge copper. But this wire would be also fine for a 10 amp circuit breaker. In the circuit breaker and cable sizing topic, please always check your local regulations and rules or consult with a professional. So that was it. Please let us know if you have any questions in the comment section, and in the next video we will show you how to install this relay box to a working hydroponic system. See you there!